Good morning and peace to you. As part of our ongoing efforts to maintain our bond as a worshiping community while adhering to the social distancing guidelines that will keep us safe and healthy during these trying times, I present to you this short video that I hope that you may find it beneficial. One of the things that we're doing a lot more nowadays is washing our hands. We are therefore engaging the element of water much more than in times past. Last Sunday, we talked about the Exodus story of how bitter waters were made sweet or drinkable, a story that testified to God's great faithfulness to us and how God's mercies and compassions are new to us morning by morning. But water is so much more than the liquid that we use to wash our hands to ward off viruses. Water historically and continues to be seen as sacred. It has been rightfully used in rituals across cultures and religions. Christian baptism is just one iteration of an almost universal acknowledgement of the sacredness of this element. Because of this, rituals of water can be used to enable what my seminary professor, Dr. Andrea Buehler, coined as sacramental permeability. This concept means, in part, that elements of the ordinary can be used as means to have an encounter with God. In the same way that common wine and bread can be ingested to feed hunger, it can also eucharistically connect us to God and community through communion. And washing our hands can be used as a means of grace or an act of sacramental permeability and a ritual of the ordinary that can prayerfully empower us to connect to God and to our greater hopes and prayers for others. Obviously, this is already being done in many religions. My good friend, who is a rabbi, introduced me to a prayer that is done while washing hands before a meal. This entails pouring water into both hands at least twice while acknowledging the presence of God and the divine attributes of justice and mercy. I have another friend who is an imam, and upon telling him my daughter's name that is derived from the Swahili word of Nia, he told me that one of the most important aspects of their daily prayer practice, or salat, which includes this preparatory washing, is the evocation of Nia, which means your intention. And one must pray with intentionality, lest they merely do things like salat out of rote and routine, and that awareness is engendered during the ceremonial washing beforehand. Even St. Mark's, a Methodist church in Sacramento, where I had the privilege of serving, hung up signs in their bathroom that said, "While washing your hands, quote the Lord's Prayer, or sing the first verse of a well-known hymn like, 'Be Thou My Vision,' and other things." The point is this: washing hands can serve more than just this utilitarian purpose of maintaining cleanliness. It can be a powerful, prayerful point of contact with God and with others. This prayer of hand washing in a time of COVID-19, which you are about to hear, was written by my friend and colleague from Pacific School of Religion, Dr. Sharon Fenema, and it was inspired by the healer, Dory Midnight, via the author, Adrian Mari Brown. So first, begin by placing your hands in the water. Look at your hands in the dish. Let your hands linger there and your awareness. Feel the water. Feel your fingers. What is it that you notice? What sensations do you feel? What feelings or thoughts are loosened in your awareness as you linger in this water? After a time, pour from one hand into the other, as if you are cleansing them. And then I encourage you to offer this prayer of hand washing, to speak it aloud, and invite into your process the awareness of God's sacred presence with you. Repeat this prayer or the spirit of this prayer at least one time. This water is sacred. These hands are sacred. All that these hands will touch is sacred. This cleansing is sacred because the well-being of all creatures is sacred. This moment of washing away all that does not serve is sacred. This resistance to fear is sacred. This way of tending to the most vulnerable I encounter is sacred. This act of care for myself and others is sacred because touch is sacred, and all that these hands will touch is sacred. These hands are sacred. This water is sacred. So I want to thank you for joining us in engaging this ritual of water. And of course, you will use soap and water, and you will engage it in different forms, possibly in your home bathroom or in your kitchen sink or wherever. But the main takeaway is to know that hand washing can be a powerful and prayerful act. And during these challenging times, to be able to connect with God in that level of intentionality is so very necessary. Go with God, and may you go in God's peace.